welcome once again to the world famous air conditioned Spectrum. I'm Matt Court from WMMR. Tonight's game being broadcast on ESPN the Deuce all over the country. Are you ready to get rocked? Are you ready to get rocked? Are we ready to get rocked out here? Come on! Once again, the game is on ESPN2. The Deuce. Deuce, there it is. Deuce, there it is. Come on. I can't hear you. Let me throw it right now to the main man of the mill, the man calling the game for us tonight. How about it for Lee Downlow? Lee.
All right, welcome to our coverage on ESPN of Major Indoor Lacrosse League action. This is week two of 14 straight weeks, and we are ready to get into the bulk of the season because we are set to showcase the Philadelphia team. We're in a tough arena, folks. This is the Philadelphia Spectrum, and these guys are tough to play in front of. If you haven't seen indoor lacrosse, you're in for a treat because both of these teams are locked and loaded. New York comes in with four rookie draft choices. They've got a fresh face. Philadelphia, that close to winning the world championship last year, they're ready to go over the top, and this crowd from Philadelphia is behind them. I'm not alone throughout the season. I've got a partner. Let's go down and talk to Christy Lee right now.
All right. Thank you, Lee. Well, I'm down here on the Philadelphia Wings bench. You guys here in Philadelphia probably don't need me to tell you that the Philadelphia Wings have been voted the best sports team in the city of Philadelphia by Philadelphia Magazine. But my friends on the Deuce don't know that. A couple of reasons are these two guys standing next to me, Paul and Gary Gate, two identical twins who are probably two of the most popular guys who play for the Wings. Right, Wings fans? Well, tonight, Paul and Gary are going to be involved in a little bit of a different strategy for the Wings. For the first time, guys, they're going to split you up onto different lines. Paul, how do you think that's going to affect your play?
We're going to hit it in two waves, you know? One on the first line, one on the second.
Well, what about, is it going to be a tough adjustment for you, Gary?
It's definitely going to be a little different. We're going out there, and we're going to try, instead of just having one line with both of us on it to make it exciting, we'll have two lines, so we'll be out there twice as much.
Well, the fans don't seem to have this reaction of enthusiasm. How important is the fan support here tonight?
It's always important. They'll back us up. They're behind us.
All right. Paul and Gary Gate, two of the most exciting players in indoor lacrosse. Well, we've got two of the most exciting players. We've got the exciting crowd here at the Spectrum. And to get them even more fired up for tonight's game with the Saints, we bring you Big Gabe.
The Mill on the Deuce is brought to you by Coors Light, the official beer of the Mill. Coors Light, check it out. And by Adidas, the official footwear of the Mill. Adidas, the brand with three stripes. And by STX Lacrosse Equipment. STX, number one in lacrosse.
Leaf, got you. Yes, talk back.
imagine if there were two Emmett Smiths or two Wayne Gretzky's, or how about two of the Shaq? Well, the Philadelphia Wings have the Gates, perhaps the two best indoor lacrosse players in the world. Identical twins Gary and Paul hope to bring the city of brotherly love the championship ring in 94.
But the boys from the Big Apple are here to clip the Wings tonight. The rock stops here. This is team MVP Sal LoCascio. It's his job to close the gate on Paul and Gary. The offensive lighting will be provided by another set of brothers, the Cummings, Mike and Bob. And third-year pro Matt Panetta will hope to revenge the 2-1 goal losses of a season ago.
And Mom didn't want me to play football.
Welcome back to the Spectrum. Here are our key matchups for tonight. Rob Scheck, scoring machine, entering his third year. Vinny Sombrato, Mr. Everything. Feeding frenzy, well, he gets great ground balls. A true team leader, Vinny Sombrato, will control the mindset and tempo of the New York team. Can they win? We will find out momentarily. We're going to roll out the rock. Let's look at the two goalies that are the best in the mill. Sal LoCascio from the New York, Dallas Elliott. First and second team All-Pros. Elliott, first team. Sal LoCascio, second team All-Pro in the mill. These two guys have the best numbers. They will be tested tonight. New York comes in with a fresh face. Four rookies made the roster. Two dressed for tonight's game. Opening faceoff controlled by the Wings. They'll be in the black jerseys. Coming in tight, Gary Gate. He's got rope. You never want to let Gary Gate get it in the cylinder. The defense wants to keep him out, but look at it. Man on Gate, and he comes right down through the cylinder. The shot really rolled off his stick, but it confused the goalie enough that it went over Sal LoCascio's shoulder. 1-0.
Number 22, Gary Gate. Wings 1-6-0.
Now New York with their first possession. Not even a minute gone in the game. 1-0, Philadelphia wins. This is a team hungry for another championship. Tony Millen. He, along with his brother Mark, are some of the young talent looking to make this team turn their fortunes around. They were 5-3 last year, lost to Philadelphia in the playoffs. Here comes Kevin Finner in, down the pipe, looks for help, doesn't get it. Game settling now, maybe a fast break the other way. That's exactly what it is. Millen now on the run, looking for help behind him, dishes it in. And Elliott with a big save. It was Marty on the first shot. It was Tony Millen on the second shot. And Dallas Elliott, one-on-one with draft choice Marty, turns away the first shot. 13-39. Tony Millen comes in with another shot right there. Dallas Elliott to his knees for the save. No score yet for New York, but they've had two possessions. Now Mike Cummings circles the crease. Kisslinger out front looking for help. No. Mark Millen, draft choice, trying to pick it up, and he is defensed by McAvoy. Mark Millen now looking in for help inside. He dishes it to Cummings. Elliott with another tremendous save. So far, it's been all Elliott on the defensive end. One shot for Philadelphia, one goal. Paul Gate. He's got it. They come down one side of the field, all the way over to Paul Gate, and no defense keeps them far enough away. Sal LoCascio now beaten twice to his right. Coach Tony Resch looking at his troops. They have split the big three on Philadelphia. That's the gamble. So far, it's paid off. Paul Gate and Gary Gate, along with Rob Scheck, ran on the same line last year. The identical twins now run on their own line, and Scheck is on the third line. So far, it has paid off in great dividends. Two goals for Philadelphia, none for New York. 12:30 left, only 2.5 minutes gone in the game, and the Gates are taking over. Paul Gate called for a push.
The New York City 0.
This is Gordon Purdy. Purdy from Australia, a veteran on New York's team, to Pat McCabe, who played on the Syracuse team with Gary and Paul Gate. dishes it inside. Another shot gobbled up by Elliott. Brian Volker. Martin back out front now. Looking for Paul Gate. Watch it. He's got room. Again, Paul and Gary Gate, you want to keep him out of the cylinder. He gets behind that defense and right in the face of Ocasio, baits him to Ocasio's right and dishes it off to Ocasio's left. Once Ocasio commits, he can't get set again. So far, it's been two goals for Paul Gate, one goal for Gary. Looking for their first goal, underhand shot, doesn't get through by Tony Millen. A fast break. Rob Scheck can't pick it up. Looks downfield for help. Philadelphia doing a great job.
Number 19, Paul Gate.
It's a push.
11-11 left on the clean.
Wings 3, Saints 0.
New York. Shot and another save by Elliott.
Push. Possession back.
New York now has the ball. Three-goal lead for Philadelphia. Only 5 minutes gone in the first quarter. Lee Felsbo, Christy Lee Sombrato now in the face-to-face. We talked about his importance. Matt Panetta gets the ball back to Elliott. Panetta wanted to shoot. Elliott picks it up so far. Dallas Elliott in the goal for Philadelphia has been flawless. And on the other end of the field, Ocasio has been having Gates in his face the whole first quarter. The defense for New York is trying a man-on-man against the Gates and a zone behind him. But so far, no mere mortal has kept Gary or Paul Gate out of the face of Sal Ocasio. Look away feed inside, picked up by New York. Sobrato now as the legs change. Mark Millen comes on. Kisslinger, one of the fresh faces. Kisslinger right there, number 88, was a dramatic and dynamic defender for Towson State. He gives it to Mike Cummings, the big scoring machine. Looks inside. Millen can't get the goal. Twice now, Mark Millen has taken shots in close, unable to come up with it. Fight breaking out, and it looks like Kisslinger will go to the box. We'll be back. The Wings in control. Has been a rockin' place for the Philadelphia fans. 3-0 lead, 5 minutes gone in the quarter number one. Watch out, Paul Gate in tight again. And they're taking him out, playing now a zone. Watch New York. Finneran now behind, trying to get it out front. The zone knocks the ball down, Paul Gate. This is a power play, 5-on-4. And that, of course, is why they're in the zone. New York turns it back, it's a fast break. Purdy! Can't get it. Elliott with his fifth save of the game. He has been spectacular. And Gordon Purdy from Australia came down with a fast break and could not slam dunk the shot. 3-0 lead still for Philadelphia. Look at Steve Huff. The fast break. Purdy checks behind him to see if he'll get any defensive contest. He doesn't. He knows he's got a shot. Tries to go over the shoulder of Elliott. Did not bait him low enough. Watch. No fake low. So Elliott stays high with his shoulders. Purdy's got to make him go low. He's got to really stick the fake to make him come off his feet, go down a little bit. That creates the shot. He didn't have anything to shoot for, and Purdy comes up with blanks on a fast break. 9 minutes left. 3-0, Philadelphia in front.
Yes. Okay, go ahead.
I gotta tell you, folks, I reread the rule book only hours ago, but this one's testing me. Rob Scheck goes to the box.
Paul, you need to turn it off. I can hear Leaf.
And Rich Tamarino.
Hey, Timmy!
Trying to get things simplified out there. Rob Scheck in the middle of that bunch. He is the new addition. Three Wings players in their box. Three New York Saint players in their box. And they're playing all even, three against three. Now, of course, this opens up the field a little bit. If you're a player like Paul and Gary Gate, this is a wonderful time to get the ball because your doubling on the defense can't be effective. Purdy behind against the defense of Billy Miller. Purdy with a shot, pulls it back. Good defense. Martin playing defense there. This is Huff now against Miller. Huff, change of direction from North Carolina. Miller with the great check. Now watch the fresh legs come on. You can bet there will be a gate on the floor. Both Paul and Gary coming on the floor at the same time, and McAvoy. So even though they are scheduled to be on different lines, this is three players now against four New York players. So somebody was released in the last few seconds. They are playing a man short. Paul and Gary, Paul behind the back. They've got a sixth sense about each other. Gary Gate beats two players, wraps it around for the goal. Watch Gate make Vinny Pfeiffer go to the right. He pulls the shot back and dips it into the wide open net. Again, watch the commitment. He makes Pfeiffer commit and puts it right in behind him. Gary Gate and Paul Gate can do that like nobody else in this league. You've really got to stick the shot, make the goalie bite, make him a believer that you're going to go to that side. When he moves, he gives you a target and you hit it. 4-0. Philadelphia leads. 8 minutes gone, and it's been all Gates. Two by Gary, two by Paul, and this one is getting out of hand for New York. Tony Resch, you look at him as the acting coach along with Mike French. Tony Resch has a 6-year player here, retired last year, great defensive specialist, and he builds this team from the defensive end of the field. The Wings in command, 4-0 with 7 minutes left, quarter number one.
Back on the Deuce, Christy Lee. I've snuck into the New York Saints locker room, Leaf, and joining me now is Pat McCabe. Pat, you were involved in an altercation a few moments ago, a pretty severe one. You've been tossed out of the game. What made you throw down the referee? Heat of the moment?
Well, I didn't really realize it was the official on my back. The whole thing started when a guy went after my goalie. I'm not going to let anyone get to my goalie. I went to protect him, and I got a little bit of a, you know, a pushing match with the guy. I felt the guy on my back, you know, while the Wings player was taking a few pokes at me. I thought it was one of them. I'm not going to, you know, I didn't know it was the official. I thought that one of them was holding me while the other guy was taking swings at me, just defending myself.
Well, Pat, we're really sorry for your ejection. Unfortunately, since you have been sitting in the locker room, they have scored on you. 4-0 is the score. Hopefully, we'll see you again soon.
Yeah, I hope so.
Leaf, that's the story on the altercation with Pat McCabe that resulted in all those penalties, and I'll give it back to you.
All right, Chrissy, a lonely Pat McCabe. Let me tell you something, folks. These rosters were trimmed down this year. 17 players dressed, two goalies, three lines of five. Pat McCabe is out.
4 seconds left, 34.
Now with Pat McCabe out, you've got one player short.
46 seconds. Here we go. Ready your position, set.
One player short now with Pat McCabe out means they've got to juggle those lineups. You only have 15 field players. This first quarter continues to drag on. 4-0, Wings lead. Paul and Gary Gate have taken care of all the scoring. Four goals for that duo, two apiece. Now it's a power play situation for New York. They need a goal so badly. It's 4-on-3. They've got to take advantage of this man-up shot. They've got 7 minutes left. It'll be four players. That's Sombrano into Mark Millen, the new rookie player. A lunging player from the wing comes in and makes the first goal count. That's Brian O'Keefe, a rookie player. This is a good-looking guy out of Franklin or Fairleigh Dickinson. Good size on Brian O'Keefe, 6'1", 195. And after all that domination, the Saints come back and only lose now or behind by three. 4-1 the score. Look at O'Keefe come into the crease. As long as he doesn't land before that goal, that counts. He beats Elliott for the first time tonight. Billy Miller gets the faceoff for the Wings. A three-goal lead now. Miller coming in, pushed back by Sombrato. The Gates have commanded attention and gotten everything they've wanted. McAvoy, J.C. Conley coming in behind him. Gary Gate, keep him out of the cylinder. He tucks the sticks up beautifully. A wrap check, and that'll be a two-minute penalty on Cummings, but still, it's a continuation. If you're in the attack box, it's a continuation call. They let the play continue. Gary Gate was in that attack box. Play continued. It'll be another two-minute penalty, this time on Mike Cummings. On Gary Gate. You just about have to tackle Gary Gate to keep him out. 6'2", 210, so strong. Look at him come in, two players, the ball still on the stick. Penalty's already been called. The offensive play continued. They did not get a goal. Now it'll be 5-on-4. Another power play with Paul Gate triggering up top. Sal Lacasio back in the goal. Lacasio, number 34. They're working around up top. Paul Gate wraps it around to the other wing. That's Schick. And it's bounced off of Lacasio's feet. Gordon Purdy. Ball comes out, and now it'll be picked up by J.C. Conley. Conley has been a veteran on this team. All the records. Look at that. A shot from down low by Finneran. Conley's got most shot record. He's got most points record, strictly because he's been around the longest. J.C. Conley, number 10. This is Paul Gate. Schick. Gary. And off the feet of Lacasio. Lacasio now getting a little bit more comfortable. Finneran back to Schick, and Schick rips the net. Watch how the defense kept getting tighter and tighter. Schick now shooting from only about 6 yards away. Not very far. About 20 feet away, Schick rips the nets over top of Lacasio. And Schick gets his first goal of the night. Second goal of the night for Schick. Philadelphia again controlling the faceoff, 5-1. They lead, 4:24 left, and only period number one. Bates, one of the new players on this Philadelphia Wings team. Now New York trying to get some offense going. Shots are all even, 9-9, but obviously Philadelphia much more effective. Tony Millen from Towson State comes in against two players, the ball loose. That's the difference. The Gates, they go through two players, they still have the ball. Billy Miller. Good defense by Tony Millen, world team player against world team player. Miller with a racket left hand. Nostrin tries to get it down to Miller. That'll be a delayed call. Now they'll let the offense continue, but the call will be against Billy Miller, who is very tired. He'll get 2 minutes in the box. New York would love to get a shot and a goal and then still have a chance to bring it back to within three. 5-1 the score, 3:24 left. Mike Cummings now, they put the players they want on the floor. Don't forget, 30-second shot clock is in effect. It's down to 6 right now. Wheeling in tight, they gotta get it off. Cummings can't do it. Ball loose. And the whistle finally will call that penalty now against Billy Miller. A cross check, 2 minute penalty. It'll give New York a chance to get off another shot. 5-on-4, but LA has been tough to beat.
Cross check, 2 minutes. Cross check, 2 minutes, 5-on-4.
Billy Miller, 2 minutes.
Here's Miller, he's tired down there. He just ran the length of the floor twice. He had to play defense and just came in with a sloppy check, ran over the back of Gordon Purdy. Mike Cummings. Sombrato, the trigger man up top. And that left-handed shot deflected by the defense of Philadelphia. They really protect their goalie like no other team in this league. Sombrato O'Keefe with one goal. The only goal for New York. He's down right there. There's O'Keefe, the young kid. Sobrato on the bounce shot. It rolls toward the crease and gets in. Crowd was stunned. Elliott made the initial save. The ball had such heavy spin, it rolls in behind him. Sobrato with more of a field shot comes in down. He can't pick it up cleanly. Look at the bounce, the roll. He can't pick it up before it breaks the plane. Goal number two, 5-2. Sobrato again. Hard shot to the corner. Elliott gets a piece of it, but the ball had enough topspin. It beat him on the second roll. 3-goal lead for Philadelphia. 2:35 left. New York wins this faceoff. And Sobrato will bring his unit down. They will be 5-on-5. They have not looked that effective, even up. But they are not out of this game. For all the domination with Philadelphia, it's only a 5-2 game. 2:19 left, quarter number one. Nico Red Arrow out to Sobrato. What calming influence this Sobrato player is. He is going to his fourth world championship for the United States this summer. Cadignato takes a shot. It bounces high and wide. Here comes the Wings. Fast break. Paul Gant with a wraparound behind the back. Conley dishes it out. Volker's up top. In close. Gets it out, right out in front. The young kid, Jimmy Rogers, gets his first major indoor lacrosse league goal. Look how he trails the play beautifully. You always want to trail the play, and he beats number nine, Gordon Purdy, getting a shot off right in the face of Sal Lacasio. 6-2, they answered the goal and turned back the offense of New York just when New York was trying to get back into it. 1:28 left, quarter number one, folks, and it's been a war. A lot of penalty minutes already. One man already ejected here in quarter number one. New York playing with only 14 players instead of the regular 15. Pat McCabe is out. Thought he was wrestling down another player, and he wrestled down a referee, and that's not a bad excuse. Pat McCabe, All-American player from Syracuse, and he was trying to protect his goalie. Got caught up with pushing and shoving and just turned around and wrestled what he thought was a Wings player down. Ball's in close to Paul Feet. Paul Gates so dangerous down low. He came out of the box area on the transition. You substitute through the box. And he does a beautiful job of getting a fast break. 7-2 lead. And the Gates have been unstoppable. Here comes Gary. Two players on. That's not enough. Ditches it out front. The check from behind, though, takes it back. And that was O'Keefe with a good trailing defense. Now New York looking to get back to within 4 goals. Christy George Corrigan's got to be feeling pretty good about his team. Christy Lee down there with George Corrigan. We'll get some comments in a moment, but he is the assistant coach, G.T. Corrigan, and this Philadelphia team with a new mix looking very explosive. Here they go. They love the fast break. Kevin Finner and Finner and over to the side. Dishes it off to Lacasio with the arm save. The trailing player is Gary Gate. Gary's calling for the ball into Finner. Say no goal. They're waving it off. Finneran stepped in the crease on his shot. Murray, the referee, was there to make the call. But Finneran on the backside for a slam dunk stepped in the crease. And that will be the end of quarter number one. Philadelphia on the right the back of Gary and Paul Gate. They're off to a 5-goal lead.
Three.
Hey, Deuce fans, we're back here at the Spectrum where we have the Wings leading the Saints 7-2, and joining me a guy who's been very instrumental so far in this game, Gary Gate. Gary, they split you guys up. It was a controversial move, and it looks like it's been very successful so far.
So far it has. We've been out there on the floor a lot, and it's been working. We're getting the shots still, so it's good.
Thank you very much, Gary. I know you're out of breath. I appreciate you talking to me. Leaf Gary Gate, of course, a star in this league, and he's doing a great job here today along with his brother Paul.
And Christy, the interesting thing is they're getting the transition going. They're giving the Gate some space, like right there. Not a Gate goal, but a Gate was on the back door, and that really kept Lacasio's attention. Beautiful job. The transition game for Philadelphia. This is what Tony Resch wants. He wants tough defense and a lot of running. Watch Gary Gate park on the backside. The ball's going to come out. Now they're on the run. You've got Gary Gate or Paul parked down low, getting the attention. And that's all you need to do to split the attention of the goalie. Shot and a goal by Rogers. 8-2 now, a six-goal lead. We're moments into quarter number two. Leaf, Elsmo, Christy Lee bringing you all the action here on the Deuce. Second week of 14 straight weeks of major indoor lacrosse league action. This is the first game of the season opener for both of these teams. They played three times last year. Philadelphia won all three. Push call, possession back to New York. 30-second shot clock is in effect. You've got to hit the goal, the 4x4.5 goal, to make it reset. And the Philadelphia Wings, a pretty offensive bunch. You can see there, 15 goals plus per game. This score, 8-2. That's a 32-goal average, of course, if you play it out at this pace for four quarters. The Gate so far, Paul Gate, 3 goals. And Gary Gate, 2 goals. 5 assists and 2 assists. Is that what I'm looking at, Scott? No? 3-2, anyway. 5 goals out of the Gates. Christy was talking about the line change. It's a whole different philosophy. This man, Rob Scheck, ran with them last year. He had 3 guys on one line that were 6'2", 215. It was impossible to focus on him. But this year, they're getting their shots. They're getting their goals, at least in the first quarter. Marty was in a little bit of a skirmish there. Number 11 for New York. The ball goes back to the Wings. 13-20 left, second quarter, 8-2. A big lead for the Wings. Chris Flynn, local favorite. He was an All-American here at Penn in Philadelphia. A great football player as well. An emotional player that has his heart on his sleeve. He can get it done. He's won many championships in the game of lacrosse. Will be on the world team this year for the United States.
2nd violation, blue ball. Shot clock.
All right, shot clock expired. Possession goes over to New York. Again, not any shot resets it. The shot has to. Tony Millen, as we look at him, shot has to hit the 4x4.5 foot wide cage for the goalie to reset that 30-second shot clock. Now New York in desperate need of a goal. Tries to set their offense. Moving it down low. Started. Bob Cummings, number 21, is one of the leading scorers for this New York team. They got rid of a couple of the leading scorers, going to more of a youth movement here on the New York squad. They've got a lot more fit players, but they lost a few goals. Guys like Donnie Borges, not on the team anymore. Tim McEntee, proven goal scorers. Chris Flynn again, trying to get open. McAvoy picks it up. Gabrielson comes on, he's fresh. Here comes Denikin. Shot clock again elapsed, so 30 seconds twice down the field. The Wings have wasted a scoring opportunity, not hitting the goal within 30 seconds.
Right here.
Tamburino resetting it. When that shot clock gets, now he's giving them the okay. You can't just run down the field when they change possession on the shot clock violation. It's got to be reset in the defensive zone. Kisslinger, who really started all that fighting earlier in the first quarter. A great defensive player showing some offense there. Rocket shot by Tony Millen. Teams all even, 5 against 5. Millen sets the pick. And a shot out front by Panetta, but gobbled up by Dallas Elliott. Here come the Wings. Fitterin settling things down, looking for cutters. This is the third time they have a chance to get a good shot. Finally, they do, third time in a row, but they had missed the goal the last two times. That time, Lacasio gobbles that shot. Mark Millen trying to get that crossing pattern. They've got to get the ball in the cylinder. You notice that the Philadelphia Wings shooting right in the face of Lacasio. New York shooting a little bit more of the perimeter type shooting. Gary Gate, his team very active off him. They work two players on that side, Fitterin. Fitterin now beats one player, comes in. Good check by Mark Millen. Mark Millen checked him from behind. Ball goes out of the playing field. Lacasio now starts the outlet. You've got 10 seconds to bring it across the midfield line, or else you'll be called for a stall. New York anxious to get a good shot off. Purdy back to Sombrano. They're 6 goals down, 10:40 left in the second quarter. New York in the white jersey's got a lot to make up. Shoulder save by Elliott, a reset shot clock, but they need possession. They've got it now. Watch out, in close. Mark Millen can't get the goal. Dallas Elliott again with a great save. Rogers, Fitterin. Back to Rogers. Turned it back by Lacasio. Good shot by Paul Gate. Bounces too high. Fitterin. Trailing players are wide open out front. Rogers takes it in Lacasio's face. Too many shots for Philadelphia. New York is in trouble here. And finally, too much pressure on Lacasio. Finally, they find Kevin Fitterin on the backside. He comes into the cylinder to get himself a full shot. Watch how Fitterin really uses that cutting to get right in front of the goal to take advantage of the full 18 square feet. And boom, right inside pipe on Lacasio. But Lacasio had made about 3 or 4 saves. His defense has to do a better job of keeping Philadelphia out of his face. 9-2, 7-goal lead, and we're only in the second period. 9:34 left. Philadelphia looks to be explosive. This is a team that has their eyes firmly focused on the championship. They want the World Cup. Tony Millen out front asks for it, gets it back. Panetta tried to make a pick effective, didn't get it. Millen now, one of the most fit players on the field. I can tell you that, Tony Millen, tremendously fit, the Millen brothers. Now Panetta from Hopkins. Tries to get a screen, tries to wrap that shot around the defense, didn't work. Elliott, outlet, watch out! Nostrin, goodbye. Fast break, left-handed shot. He is too accurate to give him that kind of opportunity. Fast break, thanks Dallas Elliott for that. When Elliott found Nostrin out front, it was Nostrin against Lacasio, and the wing showing that they have the shooting ability, the great accuracy to make it a long day for Lacasio. 10-2, 8-goal lead. Check. Check gets hammered, no goal. Step in the cylinder. You can shoot, launch yourself across the cylinder if you don't land before the ball breaks the plane. Lacasio has had a very active first half. His defense not doing a job of keeping Philadelphia out of that cylinder right in front of him. Shot by O'Keefe. He's looked pretty good, the young kid. He already has one goal, and that was a good shot. Back door. O'Keefe for the corner, and another great save by Elliott. Well, the young kid, Brian O'Keefe, who looks really good in the offense, is going into the box. 5 straight goals by Philly. Give him an 8-goal lead. Watch the shot by O'Keefe. Good shoulder save by Elliott as he brings it up. And the hit on O'Keefe down the lower part of the screen. He retaliated. And they saw a retaliation. They send O'Keefe to the box. Dallas Elliott doing a great job. But look at the way the defense protects him. Nobody gets their shots in right on top of him. At least not as much as his team delivers to the other side. Now they'll start with Paulgate up front. That's Gary with the ball. Paulgate right there triggering the quarterback position. Sheck down low to Denikin. This is Gary. Paulgate. Sheck's got a shot from there. Again, Sheck got the Paulgate. Paulgate beats two players. Goodbye. Paulgate, and how about that? Two players on him. You've got to play the body. They don't play the body. He goes right between the two defenders, and he has nothing but white net to shoot at. You can't let Paul or Gary get that close to your goalie. He'll beat him every time. J.C. Conley looks in tight to Gary. No, that is Paulgate. He got hit in the chin. Vinny Sombrato now with the ball up to Kisslinger. 11-2, a 9-goal lead with 7 left. Second period. Constantly, this New York team, of course, that was a power play goal, but they're letting the shots come from too close. These goalies are big. They like to know where the shots are coming from. If you get in too close, it's impossible. Paulgate. Good save by Lacasio, and Paulgate will be a little bit tired. This will be a chance for New York to get a good shot. They only have two players to beat, 3-on-2. Trailing player, Kisslinger, behind the back, and a shot. A goal by Kisslinger, 3-on-2, good fast break by the New York team. Paulgate had the fast break on the other end. He was too tired to run back and play defense. Now they come down 3-on-2, watch him work it. Kisslinger's now rolling out in front. He gets the ball back right there, rolls around, behind the back shot, and he beats Dallas Elliott. One more time, it'll come down low. Now the defense comes. See Elliott against the pipe. Now up top, he rolls. Elliott not positioned to protect the far pipe. And beautifully placed, I should say, by Kisslinger. The third goal for the Saints. They need a bunch more than that. Kisslinger's first goal of the game. 6 minutes left. 11-3. The Wings.
Steve Kisslinger, the number 27. Mike Cummings. Another goal, 7-28.
Well, it was a crazy first quarter. A lot of folks in the penalty box. But things are starting to settle down now, and the Gates are taking over. All right, Christy, what's that brain trust down there thinking? They must be pretty happy.
Well, Leaf, they're very happy down here right now on the Philadelphia Wings bench. And joining me is assistant coach George Corrigan, along with Tony Rush. You guys are handling the duties this year. Obviously, the strategy's working.
Yeah, we've shot well so far, Christy. Both Gates are playing on separate lines this year, and so far it's tough to cover. It's tough to cover when on different lines, and our guys are playing fairly well right now.
Great. George is also a Philadelphia Wings veteran. You miss being out there on the field?
Yeah, but I don't miss taking all the bumps and bruises.
Thanks a lot. George Corrigan, he is the assistant coach here for the Wings, and obviously with almost a blowout in the second period, things are going well for them. Leaf.
Hey, Christy, you can be a buddy of his. It's GT to all his friends. Fast break again for the Wings. It's 3-on-1. Panetta, the only defender. Panetta now to the wing to Finneran. Back to Gary Gate. He's hammered! Gary Gate leveled from behind by Krause. That was an automatic goal, so Krause had to take out Gary Gate. If Gary Gate stands there without any defense, it's an automatic. Watch. Finneran back to Gary. Now he would make two fakes and it would be an easy goal. But Krause comes from behind and takes him out of the offense. New York will take their chances. They'll be short. It'll be 5-on-4. Power play for the Wings coming up with an 8-goal lead.
Here we go.
5-on-4. Not that they need any help. The Wings with an 8-goal lead now have a chance to go up by 9. Again, they start with Paulgate out front. This is Sheck getting it down low to Nostrand. Or that's Denikin now. They move that lower player around. This is Paul Denikin, but now he doesn't have the ball because Purdy has it. Look at the loose balls. Philadelphia leading there 28-21. Not dramatic. I think the dramatic thing is that most of their offense has been in a fast break, in-your-face style that has taken it right down the throat and right in the face of Lacasio. and they are great finishers on the Philadelphia team. New York don't have the great finishers, and their outside shots just aren't effective. Good team defense by the wings, making them take those poor percentage shots from around the perimeter. Philadelphia now still 5-on-4. They tried the blindside pass. Finneran did. It didn't go cleanly. Watch out. Fast break the other way if they don't pay attention. Purdy dishes it out front. Sombrato will be wide open. Cummings on the far side. He's got Cummings. He finds him. Dishes it off in a slam dunk goal by Cummings. Mistake by the Wings gave the opportunity to New York. They saw a fast break. They saw the opportunity for it, and they grabbed it. A 3-on-2. Sombrato now sees Cummings down low. Gives him the no-look feed, and Cummings slam dunks it. Watch him look behind, doesn't even look at who he's feeding it to. Aliak has to go far right to far left. Easy goal for Bob Cummings, and thank Vinny Sombrato for setting it up on the fast break. Something we just talked about, you're watching it at home seeing the same thing. Most of the fast break goals for Philadelphia are very effective. That's one of the only times we saw New York on the run with a good finish to get a goal. 11-4. 3 minutes left, second quarter. Big lead for the Wings.
11-19, the time of the goal. Wings 11, Saints.
First time today that the New York squad has scored two in a row. If you're looking for a little bit of light in the tunnel, that might be it. Still, though, they scored shorthanded. So it's a 5-on-4 for the Wings. Hallgate wraps it around, and then again. Ocasio is wondering, when do I get help? Paul Dennigan comes flying in from the right of the screen. Watch, he comes flying in on the run, picks it up, and just bounces it in past Sal Ocasio. The defense didn't see Dennigan coming in from the bench area, and he cut right into the middle of that man-down defense. 12-4, 2:20 left, second quarter.
Number 18, Robert Sheck. Time to go 12-10, Paul Dedekin, Gary King, Robert
Jack. Wings 12. Hard shot to the corner. Easy pickup by Lacasio. He has not had a chance to get settled today. Looking for a fast break all the way down.
Take your tickets to the anticipated ground round. You'll receive a free order of wings and a special of buckets of bullets.
Christy, what's going on down that hot and heavy Philadelphia Wings area?
Well, Leaf, you know, we were talking to Dallas Aliok after the Baltimore game a couple of weeks ago, and he told us he was darn ready for this game. He was fired up, and he is ready to show that Sal Ocasio is not the best goalie in the league. And by golly, he's having that opportunity tonight with the Wings lead 12-4, and the Wings bench is really fired up for this.
Well, it shows on the scoreboard, but right now New York making a little bit of a move of their own. Oliver Marty, another one of the rookies that looks so good coming into this season. Oliver Marty, a Canadian who played at Brown, makes it 12-5. Watch Marty with the finish. This is why they got this kid. He is a finisher. Much like you see the Gates come down, they really know how to finish it off. The American field player is more used to shooting from the outside. Marty was an excellent pick for the New York squad. Didn't think he'd play tonight because in practice he got nailed in the face with a ball. Christy will talk to him later about that, I'm sure, in the second half. But he had a bloody nose and mouth. Didn't even, wasn't sure he could play tonight. 12-5, 1 minute left, second quarter. Three of the last four goals scored by New York. Again, they come and put pressure. Bob Cummings wraps that shot around Dedekin, but Elliott. Christy talked about his focus on this game, and he has been sensational. That's the halftime clock you see click ticking down, and they get wrapped up in the crease area. Two players absolutely tackling Gary Gate. Now, fast break the other end. Purdy can't find it. He can't find it to give to Panetta. No way. McAvoy was down there to play defense. Back to Panetta now. And a bounce shot, easy save by Elliott. 18 seconds left. Push gives the ball back to New York. Shot clock, no factor. 15 left, second period. 7-goal lead by the Wings. What a great chance for them to have the last goal of the half. That shot won't do it. redirection won't do it. They're about 6 yards away from the goal with those shots hitting the net above Dallas Elliott. Six clicks of the top of the clock, and that'll be the halftime. All Philadelphia. It's been gate after gate. The offense rolling from the spectrum. Philadelphia stay with the Stars, the Major Indoor Lacrosse League stay, the Philadelphia Airport Marriott. Welcome back to Philadelphia, the Spectrum, for our Coors Light halftime report. And I'll tell you what, halftime came none too soon for the New York Saints. It has been an absolutely brutal first half. It started off bad in the first quarter when Paul and Gary Gay scored the first four goals. 12-5 is the score at halftime, but it was that first quarter run by the Gates that really got things off to a bad start for New York. Philadelphia looks fantastic. The new lineup we talked about, splitting the Gates and Sheck, three guys that are 6'2", 215, putting them all on a different line, has paid great dividends. They are leading the scoring parade for Philadelphia, and they are really dominating this game. For the New York team, they've got to come back and play some good team defense to keep them out of the cylinder. When you look at the stats, the 12-5 score is lopsided, but nothing else that lopsided. Philadelphia leading in loose balls by six. The saves, of course, Philadelphia. Dallas Elliott on fire. Extra man, two for Philadelphia, three for New York, but they've got to play better team defense to get back in this game. We'll be back with more of our Coors Light halftime report in just a minute.
Where the Wings lead the Saints 12-5. I'm Christy Lee, and joining us in the crowd from the Philadelphia Flyers, Eric Lindros. He's a big guy having a good time tonight. You can catch NHL action Fire on Ice on ESPN2. We bring you the Chicago Blackhawks taking on the Detroit Red Wings tomorrow at 7:30 right here on the Deuce. Hey, and here we are on the Philadelphia Wings bench. It's halftime still. I'm Christy Lee, and joining me now, Tommy Young, you got knocked down in the first quarter. Pat McCabe really hit you hard. How you feeling?
Well, I'm feeling all right, but I know tomorrow morning I won't be feeling too well. As long as I'm running, I'll be all right.
Well, we got a little ice going here, Tommy. I think that'll help him, yeah. Has anything like this ever happened to you in a game?
A few times I've been hit pretty hard, but this is, in the 7 years I've been working, this is the hardest I've been hit.
Well, on a serious note, we did have a chance to talk to Pat a little bit after that happened, that incident, and he told us he honestly did not know that there was a referee on his back. Does that excuse his actions at all?
Well, I can't feel that way.
All right. Well, thanks a lot, Tommy. Go out there and get him and try to stay on your feet. We'll take care of Tommy, and we'll go into a break and be back with more action here at the Spectrum.
Third quarter action underway. 12-5, the Philadelphia team leading. And that is on the back of Paul and Gary Gate primarily. They have, Paul has 4 goals, 2 assists. Gary has 2 and 2. Rob Scheck, 1 goal, 2 assists. That's the big three. They split up 7 goals between them. And the Gates, Paul and Gary right there. 6 goals and 4 assists if you add them up. They've been doing a great job. If you're a New York Saint fan, you have to look at the last 4 goals of the first half. Kissinger, Cummings, and the new kid, Marty. That was 3 of the 4 goals. Denikin scored once for Philadelphia, but they scored 3 of the last 4. A good sign for New York. It was a very bizarrely paced first half, definitely all in favor of the Philadelphia Wings. Finneran now with the ball. Finneran, All-American from Ohio Wesleyan. Good dunk move. He got the stick out of the way of the defender. Follow up by Gary Gate. Bounce shot wide. Gary Gate makes it so hard to get the ball. Not collected by Lacasio. Watch out. Denikin with the fake. And Lacasio is forced to make another save. Denikin steps in the crease. Ball goes back to New York. No, yes, they'll give it back to New York. Lacasio saying, what do I have to do? No, they're pushes the call. They're giving it back to Philadelphia. But watch how they get right in the face. Denikin comes into the fake. Great save by Lacasio. He's had to make 3 saves in the first moments of the second half. High shot goes wide. Follow up. Rope. Lacasio has looked sensational, but the team is not helping him. Too many shots by Philadelphia. This is about the 5th shot in the last 30 seconds. They keep getting the rebounds. The defense not getting people down. New York should be much more physical. Get possession and get it out of Lacasio's face. He's doing the job. Where is his defense? Sombrato bounces it off the back glass. Easy pickup for the speedy transition team of Philadelphia. Paul Gate trying to get it cleanly. Volker with a shot. Ball loose. Picked up by New York. Volker trying to knock it out of the stick of the defense. Lacasio picks it up. Sloppy play for New York on the defensive end. Hasn't cost him yet. 1 goal so far. It did cost him the Gabrielson goal. Scott Gabrielson with goal number 13 for the Wings. 13-5. 8-goal lead. This is Cattagnato. Cattagnato coming into the right hand, but Elliott just taking away every angle. And you see Rob Cattagnato came down. He really didn't force himself into the cylinder. Elliott knew he had no angle. He drops to his knees, makes the save. 12:37 left, third quarter. Leif Elsmo, Christy Lee. The Deuce coverage of major indoor lacrosse league action. This is Tony Resch. That man can play some defense, folks. Was in Australia playing defense for the United States World Team in the field lacrosse department. Had a great career here. And the New York Saints, second in the middle defense, allowing 11.1 goals last year. But where is that team defense this year? 5-on-4. Now the New York Saints looking to get a good shot. Bounces it off of Elliott's leg. Millen outside trying to get it. Millen does. Cummings to his left. He gives it to Bob Cummings. Cummings back up to Millen. Millen will take the shot. Little dink back to the far corner. And Krause can't get the shot to fall. Good defense by the Wings goalie Dallas Elliott. 12 minutes left. And this power play. The first time so far they haven't scored. New York perfect in the first half. 2 chances, 2 goals in the power play department. The Gates back out causing havoc. This is Gary. They're so great at faking the moves. Gary Gate powering in. Ball loose. Checked out from the backside. Good help. Ball into the crowd. Tony Millen did a great job of helping out on defense. The Gates come up with a blank for the first time today. We'll be back. 13-8, Philadelphia wins. Big 8-goal lead as Bob Cummings inbounds for New York. The only goal in the second half won by the captain, Scott Gabrielson, for Philadelphia. Now still 5-on-4 for New York. They want to get a good shot here. They are 2-for-2 so far on power plays. Millen gets a shot deflected. Defense pushed into it real tight. They've got to move the ball, move the ball. There's Millen looking for help. Back door taken away by the defense of Gabrielson. Elliott can't pick it up. Shot clock expires. It'll go over to Philadelphia. Very, very weak-looking power play for New York. They were standing around a lot. If you don't move the ball, how do you move the defense? There's only four guys playing defense, five guys playing offense, but if you don't make the passes, you don't test the four guys. So New York gave Philadelphia the chance to come back now on an even keel, 5-5. Nope, not yet. My fault. Right now it's 1, 2, 3, 4 for the Wings. In tight. Oh, an easy shot. He had Nicasio baited to the far side. He couldn't put it behind him. Denikin, with a great move, does not get the goal. Still 13-5, and still another chance. Still a power play. Mike Cummings now looking to get it up top. Kisslinger. They're confused a little bit. This is Purdy. Purdy makes the big fake. Wraps it around his shoulder. No angle. Couldn't get it to fall. Now the fast break again for the Wings. They love to run. Three guys back for New York. New York doing a little bit of a better job of cutting down the transition. Kevin Finneran rewrote all the record books at Ohio Wesleyan. Kevin Finneran did. A Division III All-American four times. McAvoy shoots wide. J.C. Conley. Miko Red Arrow now, a tired Wings defense, is trying to get back. Here goes Miko Red Arrow, dishes back to the trailing player. And Gordon Purdy now looking for help. This is Cummings. Mike Cummings with a shot that goes wide. And it gives Philadelphia a chance to get their fast break going. Now they can put fresh legs, and they bring it up away from the substitution box. Kevin Finneran showing he's got great legs. This is his third sprint down, trying to find the trailing player. It was Gary Gates. Push call against Denikin. Now they're going to call it on Denikin. Give the ball to New York. Ball be loose. Watch the push coming in here. Believe it or not, Denikin, the man in the middle of that sandwich, got called for the push. Ball goes back to New York. Shots 28-24 in favor of Philadelphia. Not that dramatic when you look at the score. Obviously, they're a better finishing, a better shooting team, at least in this point of the young season. Matt Panetta, All-American from Hopkins, tries to dish it inside to Mark Millen. Millen wasn't even looking, being ridden there defensively by Rogers. McAvoy. Mark Millen really ragging him. 8:47 left, 13-5. It's been all Philadelphia in the black and gray. Gary Gate, so tough to guard with one man. Watch the help. They play one-on-one man against him, and then they back up underneath the gates with a zone. That's Doc Daugherty's style coming into this game, although they haven't had many settled situations. A lot of transition. The transition game has been killing New York. Tony Millen. Hold call on Bill Miller. Sombrato settles things down to the right. He'll try to quarterback an offensive push. Bob Cummings. The Cummings brothers leading the offense. Oh, tried to get into Tony Millen. He could not pick it up. Push call against Rogers. Rogers and Millen really going after it. So New York still trying to get their first goal of the second half. They're down by 8.
Text.
Mark Millen triggers the offense for New York. He brings it in. We've got 7:50 left in the third period. Shot goes over the goal. Here comes Philadelphia. They can run with the best teams in the league. Hustle index, Philadelphia gobbling up more ground balls, and that's why this transition has been so effective. 44-33 in that department. Sombrato now tries to settle things down. Shot clock down to 20. O'Keefe. No, that was Marty, I should say. Marty out of bounds with the pass back to Philadelphia. Chris Flynn will inbound. Now they'll put fresh legs on the floor. It'll be Paul Gates' unit. Philadelphia Wings, look at that defense. 10.8 goals per game last year. That led the mill. And not only a great goalie, but you can see the team defense, how excellent it is for the Philadelphia Wings. Nostrin from the side, left-hander misses that shot opportunity, that goal opportunity. Billy Miller keeping the ball down the offensive end of the field.
Play the ball, man. Play the ball.
Huff from North Carolina. Mike Cummings. Mike Cummings in for the push and the shot. Wide and off the mark. A push from behind. It'll be Philadelphia ball. This team from Philadelphia led by a guy that's been around for a long time, J.C. Conley. Christy, you got him right now.
Hey, Leaf, I'm down here with J.C. Conley. J.C., you've been on this Wings team since the inception, 8 years. How do you feel about 1994?
I'll tell you, it's been getting tougher these last few years. We used to practice down our way near the Maryland line, and now we practice all the way up here. So it's a little bit more traveling the last few years, and I'm not sure how, you know, much longer these legs are going to carry me.
That was what I was going to ask next. What do you have to do to prepare? I don't mean to say that you're an old guy or anything, but how do you prepare for games these days?
Well, I just do a lot of running during the week because, you know, we only practice once a week, which is not, definitely is not enough time to get yourself in shape.
J.C. Conley, a veteran with the Wings, and he's doing a great job here tonight. Leaf!
Another veteran is Chris Flynn, and he just rocketed that goal right past Sal Ocasio. A high-velocity cannon shot that was set up by the Gate boys. Watch it come down deep. Watch all the attention they give to Gary Gate, but it's Chris Flynn now wide open in the cylinder, and he just finds the corner. Hard shot, beats Lacrosse inside. 14-5. Chris Flynn, a favorite of this town. First goal tonight. Great All-American at Penn, right down the street from the Spectrum. Saved by Lacasio. Oh, loose, another shot. Lacasio gobbles it up. New York's got to pick it up. Finneran in the crease is the violation. It'll be New York ball. Last goal by Chris Flynn. Chrissy, you got him now on the sideline.
That's right, Leaf. Joining me on the bench is Chris Flynn. You just scored the first goal of the season.
Yeah, pretty excited about it. Wasn't a big goal, but everyone's pulling together tonight. Everyone's playing well. Everyone's hitting their shot. So we're all real happy.
Chris, you're a hometown boy. You're a hometown favorite here. You like playing in front of the Spectrum crowd?
Sure do. It's the best part of the game. You got all the fans down here rooting for you. They come afterwards and meet you. And they think you're, you know, bigger than life sometimes. But we have a great time when we're out here. All the guys do.
Great. Thanks a lot. That's Chris Flynn. He just scored his first goal of the season as the Wings lead the Saints 14-5. Back to you, Leaf.
All right, Chrissy. Paul Denikin. Foul by him puts him in for a minor penalty, a 2-minute penalty in the box for Philadelphia. Let's watch how this thing got set up. Denikin right up to the head. Anything up over the shoulders will put you in the penalty box. So New York with another chance for a power play goal, and boy, do they need it. 9 goals down. This is a huge lead in the Major Indoor Lacrosse League. Now Mark Millen out front. Nice shot and a save by Dallas Elliott. 12 minutes, New York has been blanked. They had that 3 out of 4 goals in the second quarter. The second quarter was a 5-3 win that quarter alone for Philadelphia. That was as competitive as this game has been. two goals this quarter by Philadelphia, none for New York. And again, that 12-minute drought on the offense. They've had chances to shoot and score. Their offense just not getting the high efficiency, the potential, you know, the big-time shots like Philadelphia. Philadelphia can finish them. And the boys from New York just not getting the ball to hit the net. Elliott crushes that one past. Shot was actually a little wide. So Brado now set up again. Shot clock down to 7. That did not reset the shot clock. He better get one off quickly. 5-4-3. They got to hurry. Cummings with a shot and Elliott with a save. Elliott down to his knees for that save with 3:26 left in the third period. If you get to within 3 goals in this league, you feel like it could be anybody's game. 3 goals is as close to a tie almost as you can get, because this game you can score so quickly. New York obviously needs to get back into the game by scoring a few, one at a time, a few bunches. They haven't put any goals together except those 2 goals in the second quarter. They scored Kissinger and Cummings back-to-back. That's the only back-to-back scoring New York has had. It has been all offense by the Wings. This is Kraus from Virginia. Back to Mike Cummings, a Cornell grad, and part of that high potent offensive duo, the Cummings brothers, Bob and Mike. Philadelphia leads New York in shots 33-29. Again, not dramatic in numbers, but their shots are so much more effective. A lot of transition, a lot of finishing. Equipment timeout by Rich Tamburino. We'll take a short break. 14-5 is the score. The Wings are in front.
Okay, here we go.
Mike Cummings gets things rolling here. Kraus now has the ball. New York desperately in need of some offense. The Cummings brothers really only 1 goal. Elliott makes that save. Philadelphia very focused as they start this season on getting back to the championship. They lost by 1 goal to Buffalo last year.
Just relax. You push a little bit, he holds a little bit, keep playing.
That's Rich Tamburino, the referee, giving you an insight to what he's going through on the AstroTurf surface. Panetta. Panetta was drafted by this Philadelphia team.
14, that's a pick.
.152, third period. Still a 9-goal lead as Sheck's unit comes on. This is the third unit. Billy Miller, Sheck. Down low, trying to get an open man is Bates. His first season here with this Philadelphia Wings team. Bates practiced with the team last year. This is his first start. Don't forget, New York playing with only 14 players after the ejection of Pat McCabe. So their lines are a little bit messed up, rotating 14 players into 15 positions. Miko Red Arrow. Catagnato against Chris Flynn. Chris Flynn, tremendous defense, and the shot goes wide. Shot clock expired, 30 seconds. They did not hit the 4x4.5. You've got to get it on goal. And the score by quarters tells it all. That first quarter was a track meet for Philadelphia. New York came back a little bit in the second quarter, but they've been shut out so far in quarter number 3. Less than a minute to go in that quarter. Quarter number 3, and now Miko Red Arrow, fast break, wide open. Tony Millen will take it. It'll be Millen and Elliott. Millen. This is why. Billy Miller down on the surface, holding his leg.
It'll be silver ball when we start back up. We got an injury timeout. SDX, the official
Billy Miller is a world team player for the United States. He would go to England in July, so this season in front of him, as well as the world team competition, is on his mind as he's down with an injury. There's Miller there holding his leg after turf. Got his feet sort of caught up.
Coors Light is available from your friendly concession areas on the concourse.
And Millen misses the fast break opportunity. hurts his ankle. Watch his, as he comes up off the turf there. I think it was his right ankle, but we saw him coming off of his left ankle. Christy, can you get any information on Billy Miller's injury?
Well, Leaf, I'm down here on the bench with Bill Miller. Bill, do you have any idea what's wrong with the ankle?
Yeah, I turned it on the turf out there, trying to make a cut. It was felt a lot worse in the beginning than it does right now. It scared me a little bit.
Well, we hope you get better and get back out there really quick. You're playing some great defense today.
Thank you.
Thank you, Leaf.
Meanwhile, New York comes down with a little bit of an unsettled defense for Philadelphia, and they get their first goal of the third quarter. Score now, 14-6. Christy, you talk about Billy Miller's defense, and you were right. He is an excellent defensive player, but he was one of the most prolific scorers at Hobart. So this guy can play the game both ways. Now this shot by New York puts them to within 8, 14-6. Tony Millen finally finds the secret of scoring as he gets down there in the face of Elliott. Elliott has turned him away many times, but Millen finally gets the first goal tonight for him.
Here we go.
Tony Millen from Towson State, who played in the national championship up at Syracuse, so he knows the Gary and Paul Gate legend. They played at Syracuse and were tremendous field players. Here's Paul Gate. Nobody can stop him all by himself. Just forget it when Paul Gate is on the move. Lacasio saying, where's the help, folks? Paul Gate gets past the two guys on the board, and once he gets inside of Kisslinger, it just winds up, finds the spot. He is so accurate, he and Gary. 15-6, he answers the goal by Tony Millen, and Big Gabe is getting the crowd in for a cheer. Scott Gabrielson's dad here from Vermont as time winds down in quarter number three. All right, Big Gabe will lead everybody on a cheer. It's all Wings, 15-6 with one quarter left. The Deuce's flagship program, Sports Night, has a new schedule. 5 nights a week, Sundays through Thursdays at 5 p.m. Eastern, 2 p.m. Pacific, live. It's still the same mix of information and fun, hosted by Keith Oberman and Susie Calver. 90 minutes of scores, news, music videos, behind-the-scenes reports from major events, and more delivered with a healthy dose of humor. The Deuce, ESPN's new programming package. Now, back to live action in Major Indoor Lacrosse. Bounce shot past Elliott. 15-6 the score here, one quarter left. It's been a blowout. And the Wings scoring 15 goals. They averaged about 15, if you remember that graphic last year, per game. So they're ahead of that pace. Where is the offense for New York? 6 goals only, and that won't win you very many games. They normally have to keep it low scoring in order to win, New York does, but their scoring is well below even what they averaged last year. Power play now for the Wings, an opportunity, 5-on-4. This is a deadly power play offense. Paul Gate out front, Gary Gate down low. They will move him around. Now Paul goes over to Rob Scheck. Scheck's got a shot from there. That's bounced off the protective pad of Sal Lacasio. Gordon Purdy now, he still has the shot clock working against him. He's got to clear the ball, he just can't stall it, and he does. Good speed by Gordon Purdy from Australia. Looks for the trailing player. Nobody's there. Gary Gate was waiting to intercept the pass. Kisslinger tries to set a pick. Purdy fakes the shot to try to get past the defense. Didn't happen. Martin stood his ground. Look at the defense by Martin, but Purdy still controls. 6 seconds on the shot clock. 5, 4. He's just going to give it up. Purdy just dishes it off, gets back, and sets up his defense. He killed, effectively, about a minute of that power play. Martin comes off, he's tired. McAvoy comes on. They changed a few guys there trying to get the ball back. Now it's Conley out there. Conley will move up top. Here's JC. Christy was talking to him earlier. A new look here for the power play. All the way across the Nostrin. Conley. Rocket shot right into Lacasio's pad again. Lacasio now picks up looking for the outlet. He's got Miko Red Arrow next to him. He goes down to Marty. Marty all alone but could not pick up the ball. Racetrack. East Coast to West Coast. Now back to the West Coast for Philadelphia. Conley inside. McAvoy in the crease. Violation. Ball goes back to Lacasio and the Saints. They've done a great job of turning back this high-powered extra man offense of Philadelphia. Holding call on Gary Gate against Steve Kisslinger. Kisslinger into Marty. Moving that offense around. Part of the offensive firepower comes not only from the Gates, but from Rob Scheck. Christy,
that's
you got
right,
a few minutes?
Yeah, you took those words right out of my mouth. Rob, we hear about Paul and Gary Gate a lot, but you're like the third Gate brother. We could only change your name to Gate, huh? You had a heck of a game. How do you feel so far?
I feel pretty good. I'd like to keep my own last name if
would
that's
you?
Okay. Yeah. But, yeah, I feel pretty good. I think the whole team feels good. We're just trying to make sure that we keep a hold of this this lead and just don't get carried away and let them come back. So,
a quick thought on the splitting up of you and Paul and Gary Gates onto different lines. Do you think, obviously, it's been successful tonight?
Well, I think it's a pretty good idea. I mean, last year, everyone stacked their defensive teams against us, put all their good guys on one line, and matched up pretty well against us. This year, we're trying to spread it out a little bit more so we have some guns on every line. So I think it's working out pretty well by the score.
Thanks a lot. Leaf, we were just speaking, of course, to Rob Scheck. Rob has been huge force on the 93 national team, and he's also from Townsend State.
Rob Scheck is a great player, no question about it. Shot by Paul Gate. There are no better finishers in the Major Indoor Lacrosse League than Paul and Gary Gate. And when you give them the ball and they're parked on the crease, forget it. Transition again, just the way that coaches want it. Paul Gate parked down here, makes the big fake, gets Lacasio to move, show him some rope, and Paul Gate hits it. One more time, all the way across. Lacasio has to find the pipe. He finds a little bit, bites on the fake, opens up the shot. Paul Gate just calmly puts it in the hole. 16-6, 11:37 left. This crowd loves it. Tracking the Gates, how are they doing? Well, how about this? 8 goals, 4 assists combined. And that is better than their per game average of last year. It is doing a great job. And they're bringing Lacasio to his knees in more ways than one. This guy is a one-tired goalie. The Deuce, coverage of the Major Indoor Lacrosse League. Lacasio has had not a lot of help, a lot of shots in his face. You got to give credit to the transition game of Philadelphia, but New York has got to go back to the drawing board and get a little tighter on their physical defense. A new man in the nets, Andy Piazza for the Philadelphia Wings. A gentleman who went to the national championship with his North Carolina team.
All set, Paul.
And he has not had very many minutes in the indoor league, but he's had a whole year to really get his feet on the ground as far as learning the nuances of the indoor game. So he will be fine. Andy Piazza takes over the nets for Dallas Elliott. Tony Millen collects the faceoff. He's looking to get a good shot off, defended by Gary Gate. Gary Gate does a great job of keeping his body in position. Millen looking into the center of the cylinder. Finally, Panetta picks it up. Ryan Volker playing defense. Christy, talking about defense, you got one of the best right there.
That's right, Leaf. Joining me now, Dallas Ilya. Dallas, you've had a heck of a game tonight. You're second in the league in saves. This guy, Sal Lacasio, he's in there for a run for his money with you, right?
Well, I think the Gate brothers showed tonight what we're capable of doing. They made my job easier in there.
Well, Dallas, not only are you a fabulous goalie, but we hear tell you make some great cartoons of the players when you're on the road.
Yeah, it lightens things up on those bus trips when we're driving down to New York or Baltimore.
Hey, sometime we'd love to take a look at those. And just between me and you, could you do one on Leif Elswell?
I'd be delighted to do one on Leif.
Thanks a lot, Dallas. Up to you, Leif.
All right, Chrissy, I owe you one for that. Meanwhile, things getting hot and heavy here. 10:31. Rob Scheck, Mike Cummings for New York. Two great guys. But boy, when the action gets hot, the tempers go. Here they are taking it on one-on-one. Scheck about 6'2". Cummings not quite as tall or as heavy. And Scheck gets the pin. Another angle. Scheck and Cummings. 16-6. The Wings in charge. 10 minutes left. Nico Red Arrow and Scott Gabrielson face off in the fourth quarter, 16-6. Philadelphia in easy control of this game. Sombrato tries to take a shot with a loose ball. Good pressure applied finally by New York, and back in the offensive end of the field. Now here's Philadelphia with that running style of offense. Denikin down low, the wrap fake. Gary Gate finally gets the shot off. Bob Cummings had to absolutely tackle him. Now up top, watch out, goodbye. Kissing goodbye. He's got too many fakes. One, two, three, four, five. And this time, Lacrosse just says, put it in the hole and let me out of here. Now, somebody's got to come up and nail Gary Gate. You cannot give him this many fakes. Where's the body check on Gate? No one. One, two, three, four, five. Look at that. Finally, the body check comes over way too late to have any impact on that. That has been the biggest problem with the defense on New York. Nobody is using the body to clear out those shooters right in the face of Lacrosse. The Gates and Scheck combined have 10 goals. Here is Big Gabe getting ready to do his thing as a new goalie goes into the goal for the New York Saints. Vinny Fiper's coming in. Lacrosse has had enough on that five fake goal by Gary Gate. 17-6, 9:37 left. Another goal. Pfeiffer gets burned by Gary Gate. Seconds out of the faceoff. Two in a row by Gary Gate. Again, transition. Fakes like he's going across the cylinder and just puts it in the net. Shot by Gary that time. You never know where they're going to shoot. Watch the feed come over from Denikin. Denikin gives it to Gary. Gary froze Vinny Pfeiffer by looking across the cylinder and then just put it wherever he wanted. Hit high, very tough save to make. Pfeiffer gets immediate pressure from Gary Gate. Gordon Purdy looks back for Sombrato, finds him. No, this is Catanato into Gordon Purdy. Purdy goes to the far side, but Purdy cannot find the rope. Paul Gate, double team finally, no shot. Volker comes over and hits the goalie, but it was Paul Gate who was nailed to the boards. Paul Gate was on his horse. This was after the Paul Gate shot. Here's Vinny Pfeiffer, and Volker comes over to enforce that one.
Yeah, a guy hit the goalkeeper late while you were on the ground with me. We had a push on him, it would have been your ball.
Vinny Pfeiffer in the goal.
That's a loose ball push, then you're being fast. I'm right there, that's all it was.
Rich Tamburino. Really keeping control of the net. Here we go now. Pfeiffer makes the save. Paul Gate gets two guys, trips over Pfeiffer's legs, and that's what took him down. And then he gets nailed to the boards. Moments after that, you saw the replay where Pfeiffer was rocked. Gate's 4 out of 6 goals this half for Philadelphia. They had a little bit of a dry spell there. Late in the second, or the third quarter rather. No Gates for a while. But they've taken over the game again. Keith. Up top, this is a 5-on-4 power play. Shot clock elapsed, 30 seconds. So, what an unbelievable thing for Doc Daugherty's team. You've got a power play, 5-on-4. The shot clock expires without you getting a shot on goal. It can't get much worse than that. 18-6. Penalty box is pretty active. Check's still over there. Two guys in the penalty box for Philadelphia. One guy in the penalty box for New York. Gives New York a 5-4 advantage. Players on the field. Gary Gate. Krause trying to defend him. Shot clock again expires and they give the ball up. They've got to be very patient when you're playing a man short trying to score. You don't want to start the fast break and give up the goal on the other end. Here they are now, 5-on-4, one more time. Rocket shot low. The bounce shot comes off the pipe.
Take him out.
Now they're giving it. Tommy Young corrects the call. They're giving the ball to Philadelphia. 7:34. 18-6. Wings on top in a big way. They lead in ground balls, 57-46. They lead in shots, 43-36. And they got a big margin in the score. Nobody's catching them today. First year coach, Tony Resch, gets a big W in his first time out. Finner into Bates. Bates has a trailer. Rogers is in the middle of the cylinder, but nobody saw him. Pfeiffer now gets a save. Outlet. Beautiful outlet. Trailing players. They're wide open. No. Shot by Cognato. He had Panetta. Took the behind the back shot. 6:50. Clock moving. Volker with the slam dunk, Pfeiffer with a second straight save. Conley gets hit in the face, no call. Wrap shot by Paul Gate, another save. Shot clock down to 11. Last two shots not hitting the 4x4.5. Rogers, Paul Gate. Pfeiffer again with the save. Christy, it looks like it's all Philadelphia.
That's right. Leaf, you know what? We were talking on the way down here about percentages, and we figured that Rabshack
And Paul and Gary had to average 8 goals apiece, or together, I mean, 8 goals combined.
8 and 5 for.
Yeah, well, tonight we've got Paul with 6 and Gary already with 4. I think they've blown that averages. And as you can see, as we promoted earlier tonight, it takes even more than 2 to tackle the Gates. They are just awesome. 2 of them. What would happen if there were 4 of them? It would be an unbelievable thing.
Paul Gates.
And as always, when I'm on the bench talking, we score another goal. Ladies and gentlemen, the Wings over the Saints, 19-6. Paul Gates, unbelievable.
Well, somebody's going to have to find a way to stop them. Buffalo has been the only team successful in throttling this offense. They can really fool a goalie with their fakes. Their fakes are so believable. New York gets scored their first goal in 25 minutes. Before that, this goal by Paul Gate, his 7th of the night. Last year, you know, Christy, we were talking about Paul and Gary. Last year, the 3 times New York faced Philadelphia, Paul Gate was the MVP in 2 of them. I think he's going to get another MVP award tonight.
Let him out too soon. The guy was in the box. You had too many men on the field. I've got to take the goal away. Let's not argue. Let's just keep playing. It's going to be their ball down here. Let's just play.
All right.
Red
so that
goal, your ball.
Paul Gate loses his 7th goal. That score will go back, I guess, to 17-6, I think. It's not going to affect the outcome. You know that. I know that. Evidently, you heard Rich Tamburino explaining to Tony Resch, their man came out of the box too early. 18-6 is the accurate score with that Paul Gate goal taken away. So he's got 6 for the night. Still not a bad night's work. Talking about Buffalo, that's one to look forward to. We're going to have that game coming up in our series. Buffalo and Philly, watch Rob Schick. Has stepped into a nightmare. Rob Schick looks like one of the Gates. 6'2", 215, comes in and just hammers it over the shoulder. It's Schick on Vinny Pfeiffer. Fakes to the far side, pulls it near side. Schick, beautiful job after checking behind him to make sure that nobody was going to catch up with him defensively. That'll be goal number 19. And the big 3 for Philly have had quite a night. 19-6. 4:57 left in the game. Well, New York's got a few things to work out. Not only their defense, but where is their offense? No real promise. They've had a fair amount of shots, but no convincing shots from Dallas Elliott. And now Piazza. Piazza doesn't make that save. Hip high, ball goes in. Good shot. Finally, New York gets a good shot and a goal. Tony Millen with his 2nd goal of the night. Millen makes it 19-7. This one's all Philadelphia.
Saints goalkeeper number 28, Tony Millen.
We'll be back. 4th quarter action. Chris Flynn facing off, trying to find help, doesn't get it. This is Krause, face-off specialist, All-American from Virginia, University of Virginia. Tony Millen, fresh off of that last goal scored against Andy Piazza. Only 2 goals scored by New York this whole second half, 7 by the Wings. Piazza knocks it down with the glove hand, looking for the outlet. Under 4 minutes left in the game. Bates. Now Denikin. Denikin fakes. They look for the cutter. Don't get it. This is Kevin Finneran. Inside to Denikin. He couldn't handle it. nobody playing Denikin right in front of Pfeiffer. He couldn't pull it in. Miko Red Arrow, 19-7, 3:22 left, fourth quarter. Panetta, shot and a save. Mark Millen in the crease. That crease, 9 feet in radius, so it's 18 feet across that crease. That's a protective area for the goalie. You step in it, you lose the ball. Tom Young settles things down, gives the ball to Vinny Pfeiffer in the New York squad. Doc Daugherty's got a lot to think about when he goes back to his practice. Their defense, which was really the hallmark of the New York team, just could not handle this new alignment of Philadelphia. But I think as great as the Gates are, the team defense just wasn't there. The bodies weren't taking out people. Got to play a little more physical in the Major Indoor Lacrosse League to be effective. Up to Chris Flynn, he can't handle it. Panetta, too tired to try. Finneran. Bounce shot by Finneran into the net. Pfeiffer will get the ball. Fresh legs coming on for the Wings. About 2 minutes left in the game. Huge lead by the Wings, and they will have their first win of this season. Tony Millen. Almost picked off by Chris Flynn. Philadelphia leading the ground ball category, which is not a surprise. Paul Gate, this will be a slam dunk. Tries it between his legs. Paul Gate experimenting with that shot. Pfeiffer picks it right up. I saw him work on that in practice. We saw it in our previous show. Paul Gate wrapped that one around, shot between his legs. Did not fool Vinny Pfeiffer. 1:26 left.
Please stay after tonight's game for our
monster lead by Philadelphia. Kisslinger again with that behind the back shot. Paul Gate now with another chance to get a fast break. Rogers is up front, but he cannot collect it. Gate still can't get it. Finally he does. Wraps it around, watch out, right in front. Jimmy Rogers took the ball from Paul Gate, gave it over to Gary Martin. This is a guy who plays defense like nobody else. And that was all set up by Paul Gate. He got the attention of everybody on New York's team. He fires it across the field to Rogers, who found Martin right on the crease. Martin with a slam dunk right behind Vinny Pfeiffer. 20, they cracked the 2-0, 20-7. Maybe one of the biggest margins of victory. Not maybe, it is one of the biggest margins of victory in Major Indoor Lacrosse League history, 20-7. Don't be discouraged, folks. If you like this action, most of these games are within three goals. They're very, very close. This one, very unusual. And with 34 seconds left, there'll be no surprise, I don't think, when we figure out who our MVP is. And we'll do that in a few moments. 20 seconds. Shot clock expired. New York will be able to hold the ball for the last 16 if they elect to. Down by 13. This is the goal. Shot clock not a factor as the fast 2 seconds. That's the game. Player of the game tonight, Paul Gay from the Philadelphia Wings. 6 goals, 2 assists. And that was one of his 6. He had one called back. Easily could have been 7, except somebody came on the field too early. Paul Gay takes control for the Philadelphia Wings. Philadelphia off to a big start for the 94 season. We'll be back with our final comments and post-game show.
The Mill on the Deuce is brought to you by Coors Light, the official beer of the Mill. Coors Light, check it out. And by Adidas, the official footwear of the Mill. Adidas, the brand with 3 stripes. And by STX Lacrosse Equipment. STX, number one in lacrosse.
Final score, the Philadelphia Wings 20, the New York Saints 7. And when you look at the stats, you wonder where that score came from, because the stats aren't that dramatic. They're all in favor of Philadelphia, but they aren't that much in favor that you would get a 13-goal differential. It really shows you that the Wings are great finishers, led by Gary and Paul Gate. When they shoot, they know how to shoot. And the defense for New York just wasn't here tonight.
No, Leaf, but boy, I'll tell you who was here tonight. The fans, they're all gone now. They're headed to that post-game party. They were out of here like that. I'm kind of thirsty, too. Anyway.
How do you like your first shot at the Spectrum? Pretty wild.
Unbelievable. I've been to a lot of sports. I've seen a lot of things, but I've never seen a crowd get into it like this. I have a quick update on Pat McCabe's situation from the New York Saints. In the first quarter, he was ejected for roughing up a ref. Basically, the referees, the officials are going to take a look at that tape. They're going to review, and we are going to have a decision on Pat McCabe. Gabe's future in the MILL coming up a little bit later on when we update you as soon as we know.
Well, New York's got a lot to work on. And they go back to the old practice field. And they better do it quick, because our Deuce production truck will be rolling up next week. We see the Buffalo Bandits, defending champions of the Mill, coming and playing the New York Saints at their home arena. So if they thought this was a great offense, the defending champs visit Nassau Coliseum next week. For Christy Lee, I'm Lee Felsmo. Good night from the Spectrum. Hope to see you next week. Tonight, it was all Philadelphia.